I'm going to explain you about the general structure of any assembly language program. Any assembly language program consists of two parts in it. One is called as the data segment part, and the other one is called as the code segment part. In the data segment, you place all the variables you use in your program, and in the code segment part, you place all the instructions you use in your program. And coming to the data segment part here, this is the program to perform addition and subtraction operation on two given numbers. So here data 1 and data 2 are the two variables on which we are going to perform addition and subtraction operations, and sum is another variable which is used to hold the result of addition operation, and difference is another variable which is used to hold the result of subtraction operation. And the size of the variables here you declared is byte. DB stands for defined byte. In assembly language program, you have to explicitly mention the size of the variables. You can also declare them as a word length, which is equal to 2 bytes, and quad, which is equal to 4 bytes in length. But in high level language, there is no need of telling the size of your variable. You can simply tell the type of your variable, like int, float, character, like that. But here you have also initialized the variables data 1 with value 3 and data 2 with value 2, and you don't know the results. That's why you put question mark here. With this, your data segment part ends. And coming to the code segment part, the first statement in the code segment part is assume CS colon code comma DS colon data. This is not an instruction to the assembler. This is simply direction given to the assembler. That means your processor and memory are two different systems. So processor doesn't know where your data segment and code segment gets allocated in the memory during the runtime. That means data is the logical name given to the starting address of your data segment, and code is the logical name given to the starting address of your code segment. And processor only knows the starting addresses of your data segment and code segment with the help of segment registers DS and CS. That means whenever you want to access a data element present in the data segment, the processor will do that. will do that with the help of data segment register. And whenever you want to access the instruction in our code segment, the processor will do that with the help of code segment register. And coming to the next part, so these two statements are common to any assembly language program. These two statements combinedly are called as initialization of data segment registers. That means during runtime, this data gets replaced with the starting address of your data segment, and that is you are moving that to the AX register. And from AX, next instruction is move DS comma AX. From AX, you are moving that into the data segment register. Now the processor knows where your data segment is allocated in the memory. So these two statements combinedly are called as initialization of segment registers. From now onwards, your processor is going to access the data elements present in the data segment with the help of DS register. And next, what you are doing, move AL comma data 1. That means in the data segment, your first value data 1 is present, that is loaded into AL register. And next, data 2 is loaded into BL register, and you have your data 1 and data 2 in AL and BL registers respectively. And now you are performing addition operation, add AL comma BL. So after the addition, the result is stored in the accumulator register itself. But you have declared one variable in the memory to store the result of addition operation. That's why you have to explicitly move the result to this sum variable. This is the use of this instruction. And next, what you want to perform? You want to perform subtraction operation also. So that's why you are again loading data 1 into AL and data 2 into BL, and you are performing subtraction operation, and the result is stored in the accumulator register itself, and you want to explicitly move that result to the difference variable, which is declared in your memory, and you are doing that with the help of this instruction. And next, the instruction is int 03. That means this is called as software interrupt instruction. So your program execution stops here, and you, with the help of this instruction, you are able to see the contents of different registers, contents of memory locations, and different flags present in your processor. All those things you can do with the help of this interrupt 03 instruction only. And with this, your code part ends and your program is also ending. This is the general structure of any assembly language program.